On to the next presentation. Next one is on, again related to the rich internet applications. It is on integrating REST with Riga Bus for efficient communication and modularity in rich internet applications, presented by Mr. Veerasinghe, currently working as associate software engineer at Informatics Institute of Technology. He is a scholar at the Informatics Institute of Technology, studying Bachelor of Engineering Honours in Software Engineering from University of Westminster. So Tiron is highly inspired with technology and his free time manipulating, testing, developing various software solutions, carrying out various research in these rich internet applications, web services, agent-based systems, and so forth. So over to Tiron.
Thank you, Dacha, for the introduction. And good evening, everyone. I'm Tiron Veerasinghe. And our research topic is integrating REST with RIA bus for efficient communication and modularity in rich internet application. Kota is Nalakaruvan Disanayake, the presenter of the previous presentation. So let's move. This is the plan for the presentation. First, the introduction. And I'm going to skip the first two slides because during the previous presentation, this about the rich internet application and the Ajax technology is already described. So I'm not going to explain it again. So I move to the next one. The REST. The REST stands for Representational State Transfer. Actually, this is a software architectural solution for build scalable web services. And there we use basically four HTTP methods as get, post, put, and delete. And the way to use this REST is shown in the slide as well. If you are really interested, you can read the REST API, and there's a thesis for the REST as well, right? So RIA bus, I think most of you are not much aware about this term RIA bus, so I'll try to explain it. Now you know, in the Ajax technology, I think I missed, yeah, this one. This is how traditional Ajax works. There's a client and there's the server. Client sends asynchronous HTTP request to the server, and it will access a particular script, and then the script will be send a request to the client. But as you can see here, if there are multiple scripts, you will be in trouble. When you need to customize and when you need to maintain, you'll be in trouble. So that's where the RIA bus come into the scene. Sorry. Yeah. Now here, as usual, client sends the asynchronous HTTP request to the server, but in the server, now there's a RIA bus. It will handle the HTTP request, and it will communicate with the module inside the server, and then send back the response to the client. So actually, what is this RIA bus? It's a script file again. So research objectives, our research objectives is to provide architectural solution to integrate REST into the RIA bus, and that is to increase the modularity of the server side code and the methodology. So we conduct a literature survey, especially about the RIA, Ajax, architectural patterns and the REST, because we need to gather some information to get the domain knowledge, and a cross-sectional survey, of course. We had individual engaged in RIA developments and some structured questionnaires. And to analyze those things, we used statistical methods. Then the experiments, prototype-based experiment. And as for the prototype-based one, we used HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, PHP. So let me skip these two slides since we are running out of the time. But before I skip this one, let me point out an important thing. If you check this diagram, you can see when the number of the Ajax features increases, the difficulty level also increases. So that means even though you have a good understanding about the Ajax technology and the Ajax architecture, that won't help you to reduce the complexity of your application. Trust me, that's the truth. The drawbacks in the sense, we introduced our RIA bus in 2014, and during our testing time, we found some drawbacks in our RIA bus, especially it increased the complexity in the sense, now if the number of asynchronous HTTP methods and number of modules increases, that will cause to increase the complexity of the algorithm of the RIA bus. And the second point is the security issues in the sense, now there's the client, and in the server there's the RIA bus. Now client directly communicating with the RIA bus, so because of that URL, so then the URL exposes to the client, so that can be an issue when we think about the security aspect. So to overcome those two, we came with the two solutions. One is a common index file. So in the common index file, this is also placed in the again in the server. So as usual, user sends synchronous HTTP request to the server. Now there's a single index file, and it will take the request, and it will communicate with the particular RIA bus, and then it will communicate with the module. So in the sense, there's only one index file, and that particular one index file can communicate with multiple RIA buses, and per one RIA bus, you can have multiple modules as well. So it's really easy to customize and really easy to maintain, because if you have anything to do, you can you have to worry about only one index file. So this is the flow of that, how it happens. So this is how you can send the details with the URL. This is the path to the index file. User is the module. You can send null, or if you want, you can send some IDs. If there are multiple IDs, you can almost separate them with an ampersand mark. This is the sample code for the common index file or the index file. So if you check, there's a if block there. So in that we are checking the module and then loads the particular RIA bus. The second one is customized REST version. So if you remember, I mentioned that there are four main methods as get, post, put, and delete. But in this research, we are using get, post, and delete, because post and put are almost used to submit the complete form data. And in our research, actually, we are using specific URL segments and add more details along with the request. So we are using only get, post, and delete, but still we can perform all the CRUD operations. For example, for the get, we are using like this. If you send null, it will read all the users. And if you want, you can send some IDs along with that, then it will read the specific users. Same for the post as well. If it is null, it will create a new user, and if you send any IDs, that will update the specific users. The delete also, it's same. If you send null, it will delete all the users. Very dangerous. If you don't have a backup for your database, then you can pay for the code. You can send the ID as well. Now this is the this is what I want to describe you about. This is the sample code for the RIA bus. for the future work. Of course, this is an ongoing research. So we are trying to come up with a general architecture structure, and also we are planning to expand the scope for the other platforms as well, for the ASP and the Java. Actually, we have tried about the ASP.NET platform, and it is successful. Maybe in the next year, we'll be able to publish that one as well, you see. And then we are trying to approach the other script-based techniques as well, about the WebSockets and Comet EEC. So with that, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thank you.